Treasurer Wayne Swan has released the key numbers in his budget update, and as promised, he's forecasting a return to surplus next year. To get there, he's slashing billions in spending. For more details, let's go to our National Affairs editor, Paul Bongiorno, live from Canberra. Paul, how's it all stacking up?
Well, Ron, I've got to say it's stacking up as a very close-run thing. Wayne Swan has delivered a forecast of a budget surplus next year, but I'd say he'll be holding his breath, hoping he'll be able to deliver it. Let's have a closer look at the numbers. The surplus for next year is forecast at $1.5 billion. That's paper thin when you realise it's a $320 billion budget. Now, it's a huge turnaround from this year. The forecast for the deficit this year is now $37 billion, up from $22 billion at budget time. The Treasurer has found $6.8 billion worth of savings. The public service will bear the brunt of that with a one-off efficiency dividend. The most controversial will probably be the reduction in the baby bonus and a freezing on indexation for that. But the government says that its paid parental leave scheme will stay untouched. The revenue shortfall, $20 billion. That's a slowing global economy. And, of course, the huge cost of the natural disasters we saw earlier this year, particularly in Queensland. Now, unemployment is forecast to rise to 5.5%. They were hoping at budget time it would fall to below 5%, but growth 3.25%. That's down on budget forecast, but almost twice what the OECD says is happening in Europe. Well, earlier this morning, the finance minister faced reporters, including our own Matt Moran.
Why return the budget to surplus when it has no real economic value? I mean, just admit that it's just purely for political purposes.
Well, that's wrong. And I think when you look at the global economy, you get a very clear view of what occurs when markets don't believe governments are committed to fiscal discipline. We see in Europe financial markets passing very harsh judgments on governments that aren't able to ensure their budgets are on a sustainable footing. We will ensure that. It's a challenging environment because the global outlook is certainly weaker than we anticipated at budget time.
Now, the Treasurer did get a big tick from another credit rating agencies. The Fitch Credit Rating Agency has listed Australia's rating from AA+ to AAA. It's the first time in quite a while that all three international credit rating agencies have given Australia a AAA rating. Compared to Fitch's view of what's happening in the United States, their outlook there is negative.
Paul, thank you very much. TEN's National Affairs Editor Paul Bongiorno reporting live from Parliament House in Canberra.